Now, not all of them take it all that seriously. You know, some of them just do it because, as I was promised when I was 21, you become a Mason, your financial fortunes are guaranteed for the rest of your life. And, you know, I bolted. I said, no, I'm not, you know, I don't think Christ would approve of it. Now, see, Masons distinguish between Lucifer and Satan. Masons believe that Lucifer is the light bearer, the good God, and that the Christian God is called Adonai, the evil God. They use as their justification that if the Christian God was a good God, then there wouldn't be this Garden of Eden problem where because you ate of the apple, now you have to suffer and you have to, the sweat of your brow, you have to make your living, well, women have to give birth in pain, etc. You know, no good father would do that to his children. So the Christian God is the evil God, where Lucifer is the good God because he'll give you everything you want. He'll fulfill your every desire.
Even to gain entrance into these societies, a man must violate the commandment of God. For the Lord has said, make no oath at all, either by heaven or by the earth, nor shall you make an oath by your head, but let your statement be yes, yes, or no, no. Anything more than these comes from the evil one.
God is a feeling experience, not a believing experience.
That's right.
Source of all life, or the creator, or God, whichever name you choose to use.
to meet you.
My pleasure completely.
Thanks for meeting us here. We really appreciate you coming out. We're trying to figure out whether the Statue of Liberty has some sort of hidden meaning, maybe something sinister and nefarious. One of the most incredible things that we've heard so far is that the Statue of Liberty is actually Satan or the devil or Lucifer.
The Statue of Liberty actually is a symbol of Lucifer.
Killing me.
But not the Lucifer that you're thinking of. All right?
She breathes a sigh of relief.
How is the Statue of Liberty Lucifer?
Okay. Excellent question. First, we have to go into what Lucifer really means. Now, where people get confused about Lucifer is specific to us a passage of the Bible in the book of Isaiah where he says this, "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning?" People have been saying, well, this is about Lucifer the devil. And it is not. But the word Lucifer here is not meant as a proper name. In the 4th century, in Latin, Lucifer meant one who bears light. And it was often used as a name for the planet Venus, the morning star, the one who bears light first thing in the morning before the sun even comes up. In that sense only, the Statue of Liberty is a Lucifer. It is a light bearer, not in the sense of Satan, not in the sense of Beelzebub, you know, the Prince of Darkness. It's not that kind of connection at all.
I was so relieved. This man had sound credentials and I trusted him. So first I was freaking out, but then I understood. Lucifer is the Latin word meaning light bringer. So in that regard, the Statue of Liberty is a Lucifer.
So they're making a misinterpretation, point blank, of the word Lucifer.
Hello. That's exactly it. There's nothing there at all about the statue in any kind of way, abstract or not, being a Satan. That's just not happening.
Now, I'll say that there's more about it than I knew.
Absolutely.
I'm not sure most Americans know that she's modeled after a goddess. I mean, they just see a woman statue with a torch.
Yeah.
And it means something to them, but that's not evil. And that's not hidden. That's just part of its history that we didn't know.